Hello, traders. Gary Wagner with the Gold Forecast here. It is Friday, the 29th day of April, approximately 8:30 a.m. in Honolulu, Hawaii, and this is the Daily Report. My God, what a conclusion we are seeing to this week in trading in gold. We're looking at a 3-minute candlestick chart. You can see how it traded very, very lackluster, but when it broke hard. We have gold trading up currently $31 and change at, my God, 1567. Just incredible when we take a look at it. Of course, traders, we thought there was the possibility of the market consolidating. We in fact didn't see that. If we take a look at this chart, of course, we were long right in this area, and I did exit with a very, very small loss. I believe it was a $6 loss on the trade. And that's after having a $23 and $27 profit. I certainly didn't want to have it erode. However, on the following day, when we took out that current high, I believe that was 1518, I issued a buy signal. I issued it a little bit late, but we still got in at 1525. That was just a few days ago, traders. And now we have this market trading, what, $40 away from our entry point. It has been just a phenomenal conclusion to the week. Now, one of the technical indicators that I looked at over the last couple of days, and I published a Kitco commentary that went live this morning. And what I did is I looked at the MACD, the moving average convergence divergence, and used it to give me validation as to whether or not this particular wave, wave three, had concluded. Now, I've gone ahead and I've entered our MACD, and the reason that I use this particular technical indicator is because it is very, very efficient in showing us when, in fact, a wave has ended. Now, I'll give you an example. As this market traded down and it concluded the end of this major four, you can see that when we came to see, this is that bottom, shortly after that, we got a cross in the moving average convergence divergence. Because it is a average indicator, it's going to lag. So you'll get the conclusion of the wave, but you'll get confirmation shortly thereafter. And you can see that right here. In the same way, as this market traded up and we concluded the end of wave one, if we follow it down once again, you can see that these moving averages are moving apart, but then they begin to move together and you actually get your cross right here. Good confirmation. Again, the beginning of this wave three, you have a scenario in which it begins roughly in this area, but you get the cross. As I said, it will always lag later. Now, here's what is interesting. As this market moves, you will notice that during the small retracement areas here, you do not get any corresponding cross. That tells us, of course, that this trend or this wave is still intact. Again, here, this is where I thought we might, in fact, see some sort of a pullback. Of course, we absolutely did not. And as you can see, when we look at our moving average, convergence, divergence, they never really crossed and, in fact, are diverging or moving away from each other. Traders, we are looking at a 240-minute candlestick chart. Every candlestick represents 4 hours in trading. I think it is a very, very appropriate chart to look at as our concluding chart for the day. As you can see, these are our daily markers, the 28th, the 26th, and the 24th, of course. Our week started right here on the 25th. you can see that in terms of appreciation, we really started this week at around the $1,500 mark. We had just tested it prior to that the week before. This is that $1,518 that we saw. And of course, when we took a look at this market, we did in fact get a very, very small correction. However, as the market came back up, once it broke that particular point, which is 1580, once it broke there, that is when we signaled our buy in the marketplace itself, because it was able to break out above that. When you look at that and consider this particular move, you are looking at a move, especially over the last, say, 10 hours in trading, almost straight linear in terms of the angle or tacked. You have the angle at approximately, well, not even approximately, traders, you have basically a 90 degree angle when we consider the tact or the angle in which this market is moving up. It's simply exceptional. I will tell you this, when I realized that I would be issuing a buy signal at $1,525 per ounce, I had to pinch myself, because when we're sitting at record highs like this, the proper move is to obviously ride with a trend that we believe is going to continue. But at the same time, looking at it in hindsight, I'm very pleased at 1566 silver that we bought, excuse me, gold that we bought in at 1525 gold. I think we did great this week. Traders, we will talk to you on Sunday for another update. This has been Gary Wagner wishing you, as always, good trading. And again, I think I got my wish this week. Bye-bye.
Many sights to see, and when I look in my window, so many different people to be, that it's strange.